But I'm gonna, do you know why I decided to make a documentary? Because I saw a documentary. I did this small short because I saw a documentary called Plastic Oceans, and it struck me, and I said, I can do something. So the same day, I called two other people and said, let's do something, and we did it. When I was doing the research, all the research that you in desktop documentaries say, you have to do your research. It's dangerous because you learn so many incredible things. So I began to research and I thought, how can I change the attitude? You know? Because at the end, I think that when you do a documentary, you want to do that. You want to change the way people think about something through information or through change of attitude. The main obstacles, and I'm at my age, I'm 57, so I can tell with confidence that the main obstacles are the fears, not reality. When I was working for a charity in Asia, I discovered something. If you go to somebody with an idea in a paper and say, yeah, very interesting, call me next year. If you go with something that you have done, they say, ah, this guy can make things. That's what I learned very early, that going just with ideas is having a 5% maximum possibilities of getting something. So if I go with my trailer, with part of the footage, part of the interviews, and I go to somebody and say, look at, that's what I got already. I have many more possibilities. But I think that we all have a natural, an innate capability to feel beauty, not just to recognize it, but to feel it. You don't need to explain to a children that a sunset is beautiful. They go, they look it, and they feel the beauty. They don't analyze the colors, they don't analyze, they just feel it. And I imagine that it must have happened to you many times in life, that you have seen something that it has just overwhelmed you.